Today's topic of discussion again is the elastic strains. Now this is the second video lecture on this topic. So we will discuss the numerical examples in this video lecture. And in the previous video lectures, we have derived the expressions for the horizontal elastic strain as well as for the vertical elastic strain, and prove that both of the motions of a particle along the horizontal elastic strain as well as along the vertical elastic strain is a periodic motion, is a simple harmonic motion, and is a periodic motion with the period 2 pi root ml by lambda, where m is the mass of the particle, l is the natural length of the strain, and lambda is the modulus of the elasticity. So now discussing the numerical examples, one end of an elastic strain whose modulus of elasticity is lambda and whose natural length is l is tied to a fixed point on a smooth horizontal table, and the other end is tied to a mass m lying on the table. The particle is pulled to a distance where the extension of the string becomes a and then let go. Describe the characteristic of the motion and show that the string becomes slack after a period of half pi root ml by lambda. The period of the complete oscillation is this. So time period ਜਿਹੜਾ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਵੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਫਾਈਂਡ ਕਰਨਾ ਹੈਗਾ. So let us see ki given hai ga sade kol question de vich. Let OA be the natural length of the string. So suppose this is the point. Let us suppose this is the point O where the string is tied on the horizontal table, you can say, and its natural length is L, that is OA. And suppose, because we are given that other end is tied to a mass m. Suppose on this end A, there is a particle of mass m. The particle is pulled to a distance where the extension of the string becomes A. That means the particle is pulled up to B point and the extension becomes A. That means we are given that distance AB is equals to A. So these lines are stated here. OA is the natural length. AB is the extension. Therefore, OA is L. And AB is equals to A. So the particle is released from B. This is given to us. There the extension of string becomes A and then let go. That means from B the particle is released. Now particle is moving on this side. Particle is released from B. Due to the tension T in the string, the particle moves towards A. Obviously, because when we are stretching the particle on this side, therefore the tension will act on this side. And therefore, when we let go the particle, then due to this tension force, the particle will move towards A. So particle di jehdi direction hai, oh A de vall nu hoi. Obviously, you can also practically assume it whenever you leave a particle attached with an elastic string. So if you are stretching the string on this side, then when you let it go, the particle will revert back. The particle wapas jehda hai, oh position vall nu revert karega. So let P be the position at any subsequent time. So let us suppose at after any time t, the particle is at point P. So let us supposing that the distance from A is P. So in the previous video lecture, we have already discussed that in the case of horizontal elastic string, there are two mean positions for the horizontal elastic string for this simple harmonic motion. So first mean position is A. And similarly on this side, when string goes on this side, so the distance becomes L, the second mean position will be A dash. So now, therefore, from that's why we are measuring the distance of P from A. This is the mean position. So in the previous video lecture one, you can see it in detail, where I have explained this in detail, that how there are two mean positions for the particle attached on a horizontal elastic string. So now by the Hooke's law is also discussed in the previous lecture, that is T is equals to the tension of the elastic string is equal to lambda modulus of elasticity into extension by the natural length. Since tension acting in the direction of x decreasing and hence negative is the only force causing the motion. So x is decreasing because we are measuring x from this side, from A. So when the particle is moving on this side, that means this x is decreasing. X jada hai kadda ja raha hai. Jive jive agge agge vadega, this x will decrease. And hence negative, that means x is negative. and T, tension acting is the only force causing the motion. So a particle A position 1 nu kyon revert ho raha si due to the tension force. So equation of motion of the particle is mass into acceleration, the fundamental equation of dynamics is equals to the effective force, and the effective force should be taken as negative because it is acting in the direction this side. It is acting in this side, and particle is also moving in this side, but due to the decrease in x is decreasing. So x is decreasing, that's why we have taken the negative sign. Because if we take the force in the increasing sense of the displacement, j displacement vade or force bhi usse direction chove, then positive symbol aanda. But displacement cut rahi hai, x jada hai ga reduce ho raha hai, move ta t ta theek hai usse direction ch hai jis sense particle move kar rahe, but x decrease kar rahe. So positive symbol assi odo lene hunde hai, force bhi usse direction chove aur jada displacement vad raha hai ga oh bhi usse direction chove. बट उरे की हो रहा है तो दोवे उसे डायरेक्शन दे विच ही है जिधर नु पार्टिकल मूव कर रहे हैं, बट जेड़ा एक्स है वो रिड्यूस हो रहा है, एक्स इज डिक्रीजिंग. सो ऑन द इंक्रीजिंग साइड ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट इफ द फोर्स इज एक्टिंग देन इट इज टेकन टू बी पॉजिटिव, बट इफ ऑन द डिक्रीजिंग साइड ऑफ द एक्स द फोर्स इज एक्टिंग दैट मीन्स वी हैव टू टेक द नेगेटिव सिंबल. सो दैट्स व्हाई माइनस टी. तो यही गल इस लाइन दे विच एक्सप्लेन की गई है, एक्स डिक्रीजिंग है देयरफॉर टी जेड़ा है नेगेटिव होएगा एंड इट इज द ओनली फोर्स कॉजिंग द मोशन. So T की वैल्यू जड़ी सी lambda x by L minus ये substitute कर देती, then what we get d2 x by dt square minus lambda by mlx. So this expression shows that कि जड़ा equation this equation shows that so long as the string remains stretched the motion is simple harmonic. So the particle is moving in the simple harmonic about A as the mean position, as discussed in the previous video lecture also. And according to by comparing it with F is equals to minus mu x, the equation of the simple harmonic, what we get, mu is lambda by ml, and amplitude of SHM AB is equal to A is given. Therefore, time period is 2 pi by root mu, 2 pi root ml by lambda. Now, the first question is the string becomes slack when the particle reaches at A, because first question was asked to us, string daso kinne time baad slack ho jayegi. Slack da matlab when it reaches to its natural length, ki wapas jehdi hai spring di natural length aa jayegi. To wapas natural length odo aayegi jadon particle A point te wapas pahunch jayega. So previous lecture de vich main discuss kita si ki simple harmonic motion da jehda time period hai, this is for these four amplitudes, right? Because in between this thoda ja farak lag raha hega dekhan de vich distances. और यू कैन एज्यूम कि ए डैश जो पॉइंट है थोड़ा जहाँ आप ए की तरह नेड़े ही रख लें, सो दैट देयर शुड नॉट बी एनी कन्फ्यूजन. सो एल इधर एल इधर, सो ए जो है ए वाला जो पोर्शन है इस एस एच एम नहीं होएगा, इस पार्टिकल सिंपल हारमोनिक मोशन दे विच नहीं मूव कर रहा. सिंपल हारमोनिक मोशन के लिए ए चार अपने को है, ठीक है. दीज आर द फोर पोर्शन वेयर द पार्टिकल परफॉर्म सिंपल हारमोनिक मोशन. इन दिस पोर्शन द पार्टिकल मूव्स विद द कॉन्स्टेंट वेलोसिटी, that is the maximum velocity. So jada time period assi evaluate kita hai oh ina char portions da aaya hai, ki particle b to a gaya, fir a dash to b dash the second extreme position, fir b dash to a dash, then from a to b, a char portions, a char amplitude nu cover karan da jada time period aaya, that is the t 2 pi root ml by lambda. So this value is evaluated for these four distances. So detail de vich is the discussion previous video lecture 1 de vich hoyi hai. I am talking again and again about this because in that video lecture I have explained it in detail, the how in a horizontal elastic string the motion simple harmonic performs. So this is the portion where the particle is attached with the natural length, here the particle has the constant velocity, but in these four portions the particle is moving with the varying velocity and performing the motion according to simple harmonic. So the string becomes slack when the particle reaches at A. जब तो particle A point पे पहुंच जाए. So होने ही मैं explain कितना हैगा कि जेड़ा अपने कोल time period है, जेड़ा अपने कोल time period है, वो इना चार portions दा है. 1, 2, इना चार equal distances को cover करना है. So we have to find the time for calculating on only to cover only this distance. Then obviously this will be equal to 1/4 of the time period. So we have done 1/4 of the time period. That is 1 by 4, the time period is evaluated, this is it. And we have proved it. Now, the second question which is asked to us is, the period of the complete oscillation is this. So period of the complete oscillation, so again the same thing, we have the period for, we have the time for this, that is capital T. We have the time of the motion of moving these four amplitude, but we don't have the time to calculate, we don't have the calculated time of this portion, because the period of oscillation, the period of the complete oscillation means if particle is starting from B, then we have to calculate the time covering from B to A, then A to A dash, which is the time calculating when particle is moving with the constant velocity, then A dash to B dash, then B dash to A dash, then again this one from A dash to A, this time, then fir A to B. So particle will reach at B point again after covering these six portions of the motion. So time period, time for these four portion is already evaluated, that is capital T, the time period. So remaining is to add the time for covering this distance, and this distance has to be covered by particle by two times, when from A to A dash and then coming back from A dash to A. So A do portions the time sanne jada hai us time period de vich jado add karange, we will get the desired result, period of the complete oscillation. So velocity at A, so let us see second part de layi ki velocity at A kinni hoegi. So as we know in the SHM, velocity at A and velocity at the mean position is the maximum velocity, and it is given by root mu A. So mu is already evaluated and into amplitude. So this is the explanation further. The first part is over. After this is the explanation. The particle moves under SHM from B to A, already explained. At A, the string becomes slack so that the particle moves from A to A dash with constant velocity. Because jinni velocity ho A point te acquire kar lega, us velocity na loho, constant velocity na loho, move karta rahega. Attained at A. Beyond A dash, the string again becomes stretched and the particle moves under SHM to B dash. Here A dash B dash is equal to AB is equal to A. So the same thing is in written, which I have explained you earlier, right? The particle is moving from B to A under SHM. Then from this, in this portion with constant velocity, and kinni velocity asi find kiti, that is root lambda by mla, is velocity nal is portion nu cover karega. Phir jado particle A dash nu cross kita, then it becomes again stressed, so SHM from this point to this B dash to A dash, again SHM, again in this portion with constant velocity is equals to root lambda by mla, and then from A to B phir SHM. So ehi gal return de vich ure dassi gayi hai, where it comes to rest. Then it returns to A dash under the same motion, acquiring with constant velocity this. It moves from A dash to A with constant velocity, and then from A to B under SHM. So time from B to A, A dash to B dash. So talking about these four portions, B to A, A dash to B dash, then B dash to A dash, and A to B. That is the periodic time of the SHM, which is already evaluated. And the time from A to A dash and from A dash to A is the time to describe. So jede aa in between A do portions hain, inna nu cover karan da jede time hai, that will be, because constant velocity hai, time to describe the distance 4L. So tusi dekh sakde ho 4L time kivein hoya, let us see. Kyunki natural length jede string di si ho L si gi, thik hai? Natural length of the string was L. So the distance covered is A to A dash L, A to O L, O to A dash L, 2L. From फिर इस portion नो जब इधरों दी particle आ रहा है, उधर L L. So कितने L हो गए अपने को, 4. So the time to describe 4L distance with the constant velocity root lambda by mla, which is the maximum velocity which is attained at A. So that is equal to distance by speed. So distance is 4L and upon speed. इस दिन आलेनु divide करांगे, सो न्यूमिरेटर दे विच आ जाएगा रूट एम एल बाई लैम्डा, एंड देन टोटल टाइम फिर कितना हो गया, टाइम पीरियड प्लस ए ए डैश टू ए एंड ए टू ए डैश द टाइम नाल इंक्लूड कर लेता जावे, देन वी विल गेट द टोटल टाइम इक्वल टू दिस ऑन सिंप्लीफाइंग इट. सो दिस इज अवर रिक्वायर्ड क्वेश्चन एंड वी हैव प्रूव्ड इट, रिक्वायर्ड रिजल्ट विच वी हैव प्रूव्ड. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज एन इलास्टिक स्ट्रिंग ऑफ नेचुरल लेंथ 2L कैन जस्ट सपोर्ट अ सर्टेन वेट व्हेन इट इज स्ट्रेस्ड टिल इट्स होल लेंथ इज 3L. तो एक इलास्टिक स्ट्रिंग जिसकी नेचुरल लेंथ 2L है वो उतना ही वेट जेड़ा है सपोर्ट कर सकती है टिल इट्स होल लेंथ इज 3L. जब उसकी होल लेंथ 3L हो जाएगी दैट मीन्स एक्सटेंशन इज 3L माइनस 2L दैट इज L, बिकॉज 2L उसकी नेचुरल लेंथ है, राइट, 2L इज इट्स नेचुरल लेंथ एंड वी कैन स्ट्रेच इट अप टू व्हेन इट्स होल लेंथ इज 3L, दैट मीन्स द एक्सटेंशन इज L. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट लाइन ऑफ द क्वेश्चन. Now one end of the string is now attached to a point on a smooth horizontal table. उनकी किता उस elastic string दा एक point horizontal table ते असीं attach कर देता and same some weight is attached to the and or you can say same weight, right, the weight which the string can support, same weight is attached to the other end. तो एक point उधर fix कर देता और same weight जेड़ा है नेचुरल लेंथ 2L सी, इस पॉइंट पे अपने वही सेम वेट जेड़ा है उरे अटैच कर दिया. प्रूव दैट इफ द वेट इज पुल्ड टू एनी डिस्टेंस एंड लेट गो देन वी हैव स्ट्रेस्ड दिस वेट टू एनी डिस्टेंस आर्बिट्ररीली एक्स एंड देन लेट गो एंड व्हेन वी लेट गो देन इट विल मूव टुवर्ड्स ए ड्यू टू द टेंशन टुवर्ड्स ए द स्ट्रिंग विल बिकम स्लैक आफ्टर ए टाइम दिस वन एंड वी हैव टू शो दैट अगेन एज वी हैव डन इन द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन. असीं इन्हें इत्थे तक लैके गए तो असीं बी टू ए तक का टाइम जिहड़ा है वो कैलकुलेट करके देना. द स्ट्रिंग बिकम स्लैक दैट मीन स्ट्रिंग रिटर्न्स टू इट्स ओरिजिनल पोजिशन. सो द फर्स्ट लाइन इज ए डाटा मीन्स टू से दिस इज द इंफॉर्मेशन टू कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ लैम्डा सो दैट वी कैन इजिली कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ लैम्डा एंड वी विल यूज इन अवर क्वेश्चन. द क्वेश्चन विल बिगिन फ्रॉम दिस साइड फ्रॉम दिस पोर्शन दैट मीन्स द मोशन इज स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम दिस लाइन. इस लाइन तो बाद जेड़ा है पार्टिकल दी मोशन डिस्कस हुई है. फर्स्ट लाइन जेड़ी है इसने लैम्डा दी वैल्यू कढ़ने दे लई स्ट्रिंग दी इनफॉर्मेशन दिती है सो उसनों असी लैम्डा दी वैल्यू जेड़ी है फाइंड कर लेंगे. सो लेट एम बी द मास विच हैंगिंग वर्टिकली स्ट्रेचेस द स्ट्रिंग फ्रॉम द नेचुरल लेंथ 2L टू द लेंथ 3L सो दैट एक्सटेंशन इज L ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड. देन इफ लैम्डा बी द मॉडुलस ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी बाय हुक्स लॉ लैम्डा x x is l the extension by the natural length 2l this is equal to because the first line in the first line we are not given that the particle that the elastic string is placed horizontally just the information is ki a jado weight attach karange ta e anna hi weight sahar sakdi hai jab tak edi total length 3l nahi ho jandi so that means we can assume that ये डाटा जेड़ा सानू गिवन है इस स्प्रिंग दी इनफॉरमेशन जेड़ी सी इसनों हॉरिजॉन्टली वर्टिकली प्लेस करके असी चेक करांगे कि पहला लेंथ 2L सी ए वेट अटैच किया लेंथ होगी 3L. सो जदों ये वेट अटैच करना लेंथ 3L हुई तो जेड़ी फोर्स उरे इफेक्टिव हुई दैट इज द टेंशन टी जदों पार्टिकल इत्थे है सॉरी द टेंशन टी फोर्स क्योंकि जदों पार्टिकल उरे अटैच किया नाउ द पार्टिकल विल रीच अप टू दिस दिस इज द 2L एंड दिस इज द L. So the tension force is in the upward direction, and the particle is moving downwards under the gravitational force. So that means under its weight. So mg mass is m, so weight is mg. So the only forces effective are T and mg, and because this is the position of equilibrium because it can bear this. So that means. A position of equilibrium di apne kol information si ki. So that's why we must have T minus mg will be equals to mass into acceleration is zero. That means T is equals to mg. So the first line, which is the data given to us, that means that is the information given to us when the particle is in equilibrium. The maximum 3L tak ho ja sakta. Te itthe matlab equilibrium maintain rahega. String jehdi hai na support kar sakti hai. So that's why इतनों भी साढ़े को टी की वैल्यू जी है एम इंटू जी फाइंड हो जाए और टी की वैल्यू जी एम इंटू जी अभी फाइंड की है. सो हुक्स लॉ की होंगे टेंशन इज इक्वल टू लैमडा x by l. L is the natural length. Natural length is given to us 2l. And x, the extension, we have evaluated it. So x, l substitute ho gaya, and natural length is 2l. So what we get from here, lambda is equal to 2m. So in the first line, the position of equilibrium was discussed for the elastic spring. So from that, we got the value of lambda. So now rest of the question is same as that of the previous question. Now the spring is placed horizontally and its natural length is 2L. So it is stressed up to any point B and then let go. So let P is the position at any time T. So equation of motion as discussed in the previous question is again, mass into acceleration is minus T and the value of P substituted. Or you can say lambda x by, now this time x by 2L again. So now forget this about this data because eta information jedi si ki assi kar li hai ki is x di value jedi l hai hai us position le si equilibrium position le. Now this x is different. Now the string is placed horizontally and we have to study the question in this form. So lambda x by 2L again the natural length p di value lambda x by l assi jedi put kar de extension by natural length. So lambda di value assi evaluate kiti 2mg. So substituting this value, what we get the equation after simplifying it, d2x by dt square is minus g by lx. So on comparing it with simple harmonic motion, f is equal to minus mu x, what we get, the value of mu is g by l. So time period 2 pi by root mu, that is 2 pi root l by g. And the spring will become slack when the mass reaches a. So it the this time will be the 1 by 4th of the time period. So 1 by 4th of this, that is this. And we have proved it. And this is the thing which is required. A light elastic string whose modulus of elasticity is lambda is stressed to double its length and is tied to two fixed points distance 2a apart. A particle of mass m tied to its middle point is displaced along the line of the string through a distance equal to half its distance from the fixed point and released. Prove that the time of complete oscillation is this and maximum velocity required is this. So what is given to us? A light elastic string whose modulus of elasticity is lambda. So there is an elastic string and its modulus of elasticity lambda is given to us and we have stressed to double its length. So ki kita gaya, I am trying to explain it. Suppose this is the elastic string and we have stressed it from both sides, you can say, and we have stressed until its length becomes a double. So let us suppose firstly the length is a, now the length becomes 2, right? So odo tak assi nu stretch kita jab tak usdi apne kol length double nahi ho, and we are given that and then attached to the two fixed points. Fir is end point nu bhi ek point te band deta aur fir is end point nu bhi aur ina end points de vich jada distance si that is 2ac. So obviously 2a is now the stressed length, therefore the natural length is a because it is stressed the double of its length. So the if the distance between a and b is given, that means it is the now the stressed length of the elastic spring also. So the natural length of the string obviously will be a. Now what is done next? A particle of mass m tied to its middle point, then we attach a particle at its middle point, that is at O initially, and is displaced along the line of string through a distance equal to half its distance from the fixed point and released. So fir ki kita middle te si particle attach kita aur isnu displace karke इसमें असि डिस्प्लेस करके इस पोजीशन पे लै गए, लेट अस सपोज सी पोजीशन पे असि लै गए ताकि उस दा फिक्स्ड पॉइंट तो जेड़ा डिस्टेंस सीगा, ठीक है, आ देखो लिखा हैगा इज डिस्प्लेस्ड अलोंग द लाइन ऑफ स्ट्रिंग थ्रू ए डिस्टेंस इक्वल टू हाफ इट्स डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द फिक्स्ड पॉइंट. उदों तक लै गए जब तक उहदा फिक्स्ड पॉइंट तो डिस्टेंस हाफ नहीं रह गया. सो पहला अपने को जेड़ा ए डिस्टेंस सीगा दैट वाज ए बिकॉज़ 2a इज द टोटल लेंथ ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग. सो मिडल पॉइंट पे मास अटैच किया, सो इन ओदो तक असि स्ट्रेच किया, कहने का मतलब सी पॉइंट तक जब तक बी पॉइंट पे दा डिस्टेंस ए बाय 2 नहीं रह गया इक्वल टू उरे लिखा इक्वल टू हाफ इट्स डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द फिक्स पॉइंट एंड देन रिलीज्ड, देन वी रिलीज्ड इट. सो सी पॉइंट तो फिर असि इन रिलीज कर देता एंड लेट अस सपोज जब रिलीज किया देन ऑब्वियसली ड्यू टू टेंशन फोर्स इट विल मूव ऑन दिस साइड. So let us suppose it reaches at T after any time T and distance from O at P point is, let us suppose it is x. So prove that the time of complete oscillation is this one and maximum velocity required. So time of complete oscillation, time period, and maximum velocity we have to find. So the data given to us is AB is 2A, where AB is stress length of the string of length A. Let mass be tied to the middle point O, so that OA equal to OB is equals to A. Let mass M be at P after being released from C. C point tak onu leke gaye si, aur P point pe ho reach karte. Therefore, OC will be A by 2. Now, the tension T1 of the portion AP. Now, ki hoya, jadon tusi isko idhar leke ja rahe ho particle nu, right? So, idhar di spring hor stretch hoegi. A wala jada portion hai spring da, OA portion, it will be stressed more. Idhar wala nu hor stretch ho gaya. Te, suppose, T1 jadi hai, fir tension act kiti on this side. This is the T1 tension of the portion OA. So, or you can say the portion AP, because particle is now is at point P. So this portion, A wala jada portion hai, A is tension T1 nu bear karte, act along PA. But direction jadi tension di hai, because particle is on this side. Where the particle is, the tension force is always on the opposite side. So T1 acts along PA. And jada idhar wala portion hai fir, this one. Jada idhar wala portion hai, A wala BP. A suppose kidney tension bear kar raha hai T2 and is the tension idhar wal nu hoegi fixed point wal nu particle idhar hai kyunki so idhar wal nu assi rakhni particle nu again wohi same cheez particle the opposite sense which so T2 of the portion PB acts along PB so natural length of the portion AP will be A by 2 now how we can say this because as I have already explained this was the natural length this is the string And what we have done, we have stressed it from both sides and attached it to point A and B. So the natural length de naal ki hoya fir. A jadi natural length si gi, A A by 2 idhar chali gayi aur A by 2 idhar chali gayi. Dome sides pe A by 2 distribute hogi. So natural length of the portion AP. So is portion de vich hun natural length kinni hai, jinni idharli side natural length aayi si, that is A by 2. And extended length kinni hogi fir. एक्सटेंडेड लेंथ कितनी होगी ए तो पी तक तुसी मेजर कर लो ए है और ए है एक्स है ए प्लस एक्स सो एक्सटेंशन कितनी हुई फिर एक्सटेंशन किवें कढ़ी दी है एक्सटेंडेड लेंथ दे विचो नेचुरल लेंथ नु माइनस कर मैं पहला भी डिस्कस होया सी ता जे अन्नी तुहाडे कोल नेचुरल लेंथ है और ए पूरी एक्सटेंडेड लेंथ है जिवें पिछले क्वेश्चन च असी किया ता एक्सटेंशन कितनी निकली सीगी इन्नी ए 2l सीगा और ए 3l सी एज इन द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन एक्सटेंडेड लेंथ वाज 3l and natural length is 2l so extension is l after subtracting these two so usi tarah ure hai ga apne ko extended length hai a plus x aur natural length hai gi a by 2 so inu subtract karke apne ko lehi niklegi so after solving it what we get half a plus x so by hook's law t1 is lambda extension by the natural length so on taking the lcm what we get a plus 2x upon a Now the portion PB भी गल अगर ऐसी करिए, is the which भी natural length कितनी है half a, and is the extended length कितनी बनी, because a was total, but x a दे कोल है नहीं, so a वाला portion यानी a भी length कितनी बनी extended a minus x, so इस portion की extension कितनी हुई a minus x minus a by 2 ये आता है, so according to Hooke's law T2 will be lambda extension by the natural length. Now the equation of the motion of the mass m. ਜਿਹੜਾ ਮਾਸ ਉਰੇ ਹੈਗਾ ਇਹਦਾ ਇਕੁਏਸ਼ਨ ਆਫ ਮੋਸ਼ਨ ਅਸੀਂ ਸਟੱਡੀ ਕਰੀ ਸੋ T2 ਵਾਸ ਔਨ ਦਿਸ ਸਾਈਡ ਰਾਈਟ ਐਂਡ T1 ਦੀ ਡਾਇਰੈਕਸ਼ਨ ਸੌਰੀ T1 ਇਜ਼ ਔਨ ਦਿਸ ਸਾਈਡ ਐਂਡ T2 ਇਜ਼ ਔਨ ਦਿਸ ਸਾਈਡ ਸੋ ਨਾਓ ਦਾ ਪਾਰਟੀਕਲ ਇਜ਼ ਹੇਅਰ ਰਾਈਟ ਸੋ ਵਟ ਵੀ ਵਿਲ ਕੰਸੀਡਰ ਬਿਕਾਜ਼ ਅਗੇਨ ਦਾ ਪਾਰਟੀਕਲ ਵਿਲ ਮੂਵ ਔਨ ਦਿਸ ਸਾਈਡ ਬਟ ਦਾ ਐਕਸ ਇਜ਼ ਡਿਕਰੀਜ਼ਿੰਗ ਔਨ ਦਿਸ ਸਾਈਡ So the particle is moving on towards the x decreasing. So j x decreasing while move kar raha hove, the effective force jadi banni si, woh banni si T1 minus T2. But x is decreasing. J ahi force x increasing while hundi ta as it is lena si. But hun a wali force x decreasing karke hai, a wali force x nu decrease karwa rahi hai. So what we will take T2 minus T1. It's negative symbol. The negative symbol lavange, so effective force will be T2 minus T1. So mass into acceleration T2 minus T1. So T2 the value of T2, that is lambda a minus 2x by a, which is already evaluated, and value of T1, which is also already evaluated, is substituted now. So on solving it, what we get, md2x by dt square is minus 4 lambda by ax. So that is d2x by dt square is minus 4 lambda by amx. So the value of acceleration, that is value of comparing it with the value of acceleration of SHM, what we get, mu is 4 lambda by am. So the time period is 2 pi by root mu, and substituting the value of mu here, we will get the period of the motion. And the next question which is asked, that was maximum velocity. So maximum velocity acquired is root mu a. So a is the amplitude. So amplitude is given to us, that is OC is half of a. Because the particle is displaced up to C. Particle was C point tak he displaced it. So this is the extreme position. From here, the particle let go. Therefore, the amplitude is half of a. So maximum velocity is root mu into amplitude. So root mu into amplitude substitute karke, we will get the value of the maximum velocity.